this collection really illustrates the way of life of an American aristocratic dynasty. From Mar-a-Lago to Paris, it's an adventure which includes three generations of the same family.
My great-grandmother, Marjorie Meriwether Post, was a businesswoman. She inherited the Postum Cereal Company from her father. Then, by the 1920s, had transformed it into General Foods, which incorporated Bird's Eye, Maxwell House, a lot of different companies.
She was, at the time, the wealthiest woman in the United States. She built outstanding houses, such as Mar-a-Lago, and received the famous people of her times, including the Duke and Duchess of Windsor. We have in the cell a very nice frame by Cartier, and it reminds us that Marjorie was the most prominent buyer at Cartier between 1930 to 1960.
My grandmother, Eleanor Post Close, moved to France in the 1950s. She liked the anonymity of France and Switzerland. There are a lot of similarities that went right down from my great-grandmother to my grandmother and my father. They all had a similar taste. I remember my grandmother very fondly. She was extraordinary. She was unique. Whenever I visited any of my grandmother's homes, I was immediately taken in by the calm and tranquility. It stirs a lot of emotions in me now. When I go back in, I still definitely sense my grandmother. Everything in her homes meant a lot to her. She would pick up a piece and tell me about it, and she used to have little notes that she would keep under the pieces to remind her of when she bought it, where she bought it. She had a big collection. This chair was one of the pieces in my grandmother's house in Monceau. We looked at it a lot, but we weren't allowed to actually sit on it. It was a bit too special. My favourite piece in the sale is the ebon commode. I was too terrified to touch it. It was so perfect, so beautiful. I found out recently that ebon was the grandfather of Delacroix, and right opposite the ebon piece was a Delacroix lion that my grandmother had on the wall. My grandmother's collection was eclectic, definitely. And the older she got, the kind of more recent the items she bought were. She had a lot, obviously, from the Louis XV, but then she later on would buy Zhaowu Qi. She loved the newness of it and the abstract nature, which is unlike other things she'd had.
Eleanor Post-Close and her son were great collectors of their period, great by the amount of items they accumulated, but also great in their refined taste.
My hope with the sale of my grandmother's collection that she cherished so much is that it goes to people who will cherish each piece equally, because that's what she would have wanted.